study of a cirrhotic liver. As you can see that the outer surface is irregular and nodular, we surrounded by clear fluid. Now this is the portal vein, and all of the portal vein is filled with the thrombus, which measures from inner about 15.7 up to 13 is normal, so this is a dilated portal vein. This is the portal vein here. This is the whole length of the portal vein. Now portal vein shows mixing of blood as well as recanalization. This is all recanalization of the portal vein, intrahepatic portal vein. This is the liver. So dilated portal vein with recanalization. Now this is the gallbladder showing you striated GP wall. Here we are, see? This is the transfer section of the gallbladder. This area, transfer section of, this is the lumen, these are the walls. And here is the longitudinal section. You can very well make up here that this picture is, this is because of the ascites surrounding the gallbladder rather than any intrinsic gallbladder pathology. Not unusual to see in cases with ascites of this region. So this is the gallbladder, the dixie, the portal vein. This is the portal part, this is the extrahepatic part of the portal vein, which is patent, whereas the intrahepatic part is dilated and filled with a thrombus. This is the transfer section of the left lobe. This is the longitudinal section of the left lobe, where you can see the liver, choroid lobe or segment 1, ligamentum venosum, IVC and the portal vein. There is ascites. This is the uterus in front of you, and this is all fluid, ascitic fluid. Longitudinal section of the uterus. This is the fluid. This is the urinary bladder, endometrial canal. So, this is fine. I will also get Marigon to the Margin. It's a part of it. Again, Marigon. Here is the portal vein with recanalization of, and as well as mixing of that. Charo Clavoman. Charo Clavoman. With reversal of flow in some areas. Thank you very much.